Good morning, friends. Welcome back to STEM Enrichment. Today, what we're going to do is we are going to begin our unit together in STEM. So last year, and in kindergarten, when you were learning with Miss Carlo, you read a story about Angelina, Milo, and Suzi. These three friends encountered a challenge that they needed your help to solve. Guess what? Angelina, Milo, and Suzi are back. And this year, they have a super important second grade challenge that they'll need your help solving. So, what we're going to do right now is we're going to read their story and learn about their problem. Once we finish the story, we'll meet back and discuss what it is our challenge is in STEM this year.
Introduction to Material Science, Properties of Matter. Angelina, are you ready to go? Her mom asked as she was heading toward the front door. Almost. Give me a minute. I'm putting on my socks and shoes, Angelina replied. Her soccer game was at 6 o'clock, and they were supposed to pick up Suzi and Milo on the way to the soccer field. As she headed for the car, Angelina remembered she was in charge of bringing a treat for the players to enjoy after the soccer game. She grabbed the package of ice pops, her favorite treat on a hot day, from the freezer, and then ran to the car. I almost forgot the ice pops, Angelina said as she quickly fastened her seatbelt. Milo, Suzi, and Angelina often rode to games and practices together. Not only were they in the same class at school and on the same soccer team, they were also best friends. Soon, they arrived at Suzy's house. She was waiting on the front porch as the car pulled into the driveway. Hi, Suzi, Angelina called from the car. Are you ready to play soccer? I hope so, because I can't wait. Yes, I'm ready. It sure is fun to be on a team with you and Milo and some of our other friends from school, Suzi replied. Angelina's mom drove them to Milo's apartment. We'll run in and get him, Angelina told her mom as she and Suzi got out of the car. As Milo walked back to the car with the girls, he said, I'm really excited about our first soccer game. Hey, Angelina, aren't you in charge of the treat for after the game? It was at that moment that Angelina realized that when she grabbed the bag of ice pops, she forgot to get a cooler to keep them frozen. Oh no, Angelina cried. I brought the ice pops, but I didn't think about how to keep them frozen until after the game. What am I going to do? They'll melt before the game is over. Suzi answered, Well, Angelina, that is a problem. I wonder if we could use the engineering design process that Mr. Taylor is teaching us about to solve this problem. Maybe this is a great time to see if we can put the steps into practice, Milo chimed in. Good thinking, Angelina responded. We definitely have a problem to solve. How to keep the ice pops frozen for an hour?
The first step is to ask, how can we solve the problem of keeping the ice pops frozen for an hour? Milo started.
What's the next step? Angelina asked.
Suzi jumped in.
The next step is to explore. Consider possible solutions and come up with a plan. What do we have that could help us solve the problem?
I don't have a cooler, but I'm sure we can use some things from my house, said Milo.
Let's come up with a plan, Suzi said. Once we have a plan, we can build a model and evaluate how well it will work. I guess the explain step will come when we bring out the ice pop after the game.
Okay, said Angelina. Let's think like engineers.
What's an engineer?
Oh my goodness, Angelina sure has a problem to solve. She brought those ice pops for after the soccer game, but she forgot to bring a cooler to keep them cold. So if we don't do anything, they'll melt before the game is over. Our challenge this year is going to be to create some sort of a device that can keep those ice pops cold. Now, as a reminder, our challenge is to create something new. We're not going to be using products that we already have. We'll be using materials to put together to make something new. So some guidelines that we'll have to follow are: you cannot use your freezer. You cannot use a cooler, because once we got to Milo's house, he said he did not have a cooler. And we can't use our lunch bags that we might take with us to school. We're going to have to think of materials we have around our home that we can piece together to make some sort of a device that can keep these ice pops cold. Something else that Angelina, Milo, and Suzi mentioned was following a process known as the engineering design process. So what we're going to do right now is take a look at that engineering design process and see how that can help guide our build throughout this challenge.